Innovation is kind of core to SymphonyAI. It's kind of existential to us. How do we approach it, or how do we actually make it a part of our DNA? We try something new, something that's coming up in the research. You try it out, you try it on real customer data, you work with a real customer. I think one thing great about SymphonyAI already is we deeply understand our customers' problem, right? And we are deeply embedded in that industry, so we know that already. So we understand the problem space. I think we get very excited when a new way of solving it comes out in the research area. So we are very quick to grab it. We take it, we apply it to the problem we know, we compare it to how it does against the best-in-class industry solutions already. And if it does better, we work with our customers to verify it, that it's actually leading to gains on their side. Sometimes the gains are in terms of better accuracy, which results in more revenues or better performance for our customers. Sometimes it's in terms of them saving a lot of time, right? So productivity gains, what they used to do in 6 hours, now they can do in 15 minutes, for example. Once we found that initial product market fit of a new solution to a problem we deeply, deeply understand, then we usually follow two tracks. One is what we call the enterprise readiness track, where we have a whole list of checkboxes we have to do, right? Or guardrails we have around privacy, security, just a whole lot of things around responsible AI that we want to make sure that our systems or end-to-end what we developed are not biased, they work as expected, they are secure, very important, and they are reliable, they can work at scale, but at the same time we cannot just live in that space. So we always have an innovation group or innovation labs that stays in touch with the latest and greatest, right? Whether it starts from reading the latest research paper that got out there, staying in touch with the best open source implementations of it. We are not tied to open source or closed source. Like for example, in the case of generative AI, we try OpenAI or Azure OpenAI models just as much. We like Llama 2s or Mistral models or whatever is the best in class that open source is coming out with. There is always these two tracks we are on, the enterprise readiness track, making sure whatever has found the product market fit is enterprise ready, and the innovation track, which means to the problems we deeply understand, finding the best in class solutions out there, the best in class research that is coming to solve them and applying it there, and taking it out to our customers as soon as possible.